Hi guys, I'm Santosh. So am I audible to everyone? Yeah, perfect. I'm Santosh, I'm from Hyderabad. I've been volunteering to Mozilla from the past like 3 years. So like basically I'm interested in web. So whenever something new comes out, so I learn, I explore, then I teach people. So this is a new platform. So this completely related to web. Web-based virtual reality. So I thought, okay, let's share it to the people. People are interested in virtual reality, right? So everyone loves Pokemon Go because it's other from reality. So okay, let's conduct a workshop so that people can create their own Pokemon Go using simple HTML. So how many of you know basic HTML, CSS, and JavaScript? Yes, perfect. So even if you don't know. HTML, I think it takes only not more than 1 day to learn and explore around HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. The coding is as simple as anything, yeah. So I'm a Mozilla tech speaker, and I speak about web technologies. I'm just changing the mode, just a minute. Yes. Yes. So, virtual reality. How many have heard about this term called as virtual reality? Yes. So, how do you define it? Like, what is virtual? Which is not real, but you still experience it. So, virtual reality is other than the reality which you are in. So, we'll create a 3D space around you, which is virtual, so that you can go, even if you are in this conference room, but still you can go to a Marina Bay Sands in virtual reality and enjoy the light show from here. So that's the power of virtual reality. In reality, you will be at one place, but virtually you can be at any place you want. And yeah, virtual reality is an interesting concept, it's not only about entertainment, it has many use cases. For example, take the example of fashion. So if you go out for shopping you want to try out many dresses and because of time constraint you can't trail out every dress, right? But how about think of it like you wear this headset and then you will have a series of dresses and then you can just swipe it from left to right, then you will wear it in the virtual world. Or else think about real estate platform. So if you want to buy a house, then you have to go there and check it. How about if the broker creates his own virtual world, he just captures a 3D image of this and puts it on the virtual platform and share it with you. So that when you are in your own home, you can still, in the virtual world, you can explore around the new house and explore, and then you'll come to know about the whole house in the reality where you are in. So that's the power of virtual reality. We have gaming platforms. We are the Pokemon Go is a very good example of it's augmented reality, but yeah, both are different. So in virtual reality, you go into the virtual world and then look around things. But in augmented reality, you bring the virtual components into your real world. Like for example, in Pokemon Go, when you move your camera, you will find a Pokemon, which you will see in reality. So bringing the virtual things to your real world is called as augmented reality. But if you yourself go into a virtual world, so that's called as virtual reality. That's the basic difference between both of things. And the framework which we are going to use for the next 1 hour, so you can build both augmented reality applications and virtual reality applications if you have basic knowledge of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. It is as simple as that. In the next slides, I'll show you some good demos with very minimal code. So that, I mean, even after going home, you could try out building your own virtual worlds using this technologies. And yeah, so these are different devices which we have in the market right now. So the technology is not hardware independent. So you can use any virtual box, virtual reality box, and it works. For example, this cost around like $40, $40 US. But the one which is on the table, that's VR box, that cost around like $4 US. Like you have, yeah, I'll show it to you. Yes. So this VR box cost you around $4 and this one costs $40. I mean, it's not hardware independent. It runs on both things, but this is equipped with some high-tech earphones. And so you can plug in with the 3mm into your phone and then enjoy the applications. So we have like Oculus Rift, we have Google Cardboard, we have HTC Vive, we have Samsung VO Box, and everything. There are like many devices which you can use for that. So it's not hardware independent.
You make yourself.
You can make it yourself. The Google Cardboard is open source at design, so that you can take your own cardboard, you can buy the lenses, and you can make your own. You can hack on it and make your own VR box. It's as simple as that. So not only the software is simple to code, but even the hardware you can hack it yourself. But the there was a friction in VR ecosystem. So when most of the people have heard about virtual reality, but I mean most of the people never tried to build their own virtual reality because they think it's hard to code, it's closed. For example, there was Oculus Rift. Facebook bought it and it started working on building a virtual reality application using our Oculus Rift. And so the platform was very closed and it was very complex. So we at Mozilla thought, okay, so we know that JavaScript can do anything. Like there are solutions for every problem. If there is a problem, JavaScript has a solution for it. So even the hologram project which Microsoft is working on, they developed a framework called as HoloJS so that they can code the holograms using the JS framework. So there are like different things. So we thought, okay, why can't we take this idea of virtual reality and then we use the power of OpenWeb and create a framework. So that's how we got WebVR, yeah, which is open, connected, and instant. So when it comes to openness, when they created the framework, we had like 5 or 10 components. And for now, we have like 300 or 400 components. So it's basically, it's open to make your own VR applications. And if you create any new component, so you can add it to the marketplace so that you can share it with other people who want to work on virtual reality applications. And it's connected. It's on the internet. So it's connected and instant. So for example, if you made a virtual reality application, if you just made a, you will make a Hello World application by the end of the session. And if you want to share it with your friend from, in some other place or some other country or at your home, so it's instant. You can just host it on your server, or else if you have a GitHub account, you can freely host it on GitHub and just grab the link and share it with your friend. So your friend will open the link in his mobile browser and he will be able to view the whole virtual world which you created on the mobile device itself. It's connected, so it's on internet, it's connected, it's instant. So if you make the changes and push it to the internet, yeah, the changes are instant and other people can view the changes right there itself. And how does this WebVR actually work? So all these WebVR applications just run on your browser. You don't need to install any application, you don't need to install any software. Not only to make those applications, but even for using, you don't need to install anything. If you have a browser installed in your mobile device, like Chrome or the default browser which comes with Samsung, the Samsung browser or Firefox browser. So until they started supporting WebVR API. So almost all the mobile devices got these accelerometric sensors. Like when you move the device, it detects the motion, right? So like the Pokemon Go or whatever games or anything you play, if it got motion sensors, and it basically detects the motion sensors and then generate the content on the browser. So for example, if I put a cube on the right side and a box on the left side and a cylinder on the straight, so when I move the device, So the it uses the API uses those accelerometric sensor, get the sensor data, and generates the content on the browser itself. You don't need to, you don't need anything, anything additional to do. You just place a queue and these things, and then you include the webVR API, and that's it. So you don't need to configure anything. It takes care of everything. So it uses your mobile sensors, generate the respective content on the browser itself. You don't need to install any software. So the browser which you have in your mobile, it works perfectly fine with the webVR applications. And yeah, browser support. So we have Chrome and Chromium, which started support like about like 1 year ago, and Firefox nightly, Firefox browser. So it got, you need to install an add-on to enable this, but like in the next version after like 3 or 4 months, you will have full support for the Firefox browser also. The mobile polyfill is like, I mean, the one, the last cardboard you were saying, it's mobile polyfill. Like, for example, if you open a web link on any application, so instead of opening it into the browser, it just gives a web instance, right? So you will be able to see on the screen itself without opening. We will be able to see the website on the mobile screen itself without opening any application. So that's called as mobile polyfill. So that supports the webVR API. So in the next, like I think probably in the next year, almost all browsers support webVR, because I mean even Internet Explorer got its support. I mean it got webVR support in its IE11, I guess. Yeah. So probably I mean in the next few months we'll have complete webVR support to almost all the browsers. And the thing, I mean, why even everyone is interested is, so virtual reality, yeah, I mean, when you think about the opportunities and the applications of it, they are endless. Like, for example, we had a Mozilla booth, and a chemistry teacher came up and we showed him the demos, and he was like, okay, most of our chemical compounds are 3D components, and it's hard for us to make them like make them with different materials. So I think I can use the same webVR project and create my own 3D chemical compounds in the virtual space using code. So the use cases are endless. So every application, I mean every domain, a person, if he's in any domain, he will he can use webVR to make his things simpler and better to understand. And yeah, so the aframe, so webVR, when I was saying webVR, so it's this platform, the virtual reality platform based on web. But aframe is a framework which enables you to simply develop the virtual reality application. So for example, if you know HTML and there is AngularJS, so it's a wrapper around HTML, so it's the advanced level. So when you write HTML, and instead of writing large code, you can write it in a very simpler code in AngularJS. So the same way, for example, if you are writing a box, if you want to draw a box in virtual reality, so you have to give the position, you have to give the borders, you have to give the margins and everything, rotations or translations or anything, you have to give a lot. So, but with this framework, we made it simple. Like, if you want to position, like this is the center point, if you want to position somewhere on the backside, so this is positive x-axis, and this is positive y-axis, and that is positive z-axis. So you just think of the position, okay, that should be like x-axis 2, y-axis 2, and z-axis 2. So 2, 2, 2 position, give it as 2, 2, 2, and the object will be placed at that position. Or else if you want to rotate it, then give rotate 90 degrees 0, 0. That means it rotates the box from x-axis. Like if this is 0 degrees, then it rotates this way, 90 degrees. So these, this made it simpler to develop web applications. So yeah, so this is the Hello World application, basic Hello World. So I'm not using, head or body, I'm not writing quality code, but yeah, this is a simple code I'm writing. So I opened HTML tags, and then I included a script tag. So that's the framework. You can see the aframe.min.js, right? Just let me see if I can. I'm unable to zoom it, but yeah, I'll show you to you. This is a website. aframe.io. So you will have every detailed steps in here. So if you want to learn anything, so go to docs, introduction. Yeah, so here I think you can zoom it. Yeah, so this is the basic example of that. So hello world example. So I just included a script tag of aframe and then I opened a scene. That's it. So I'll show it on the presentation now. So now you got it. So yeah, so I have a script tag and an A scene. So whatever content I put in this A scene, so this will be projected into the 3D environment and shows to the user. So now let's build this one. So I have a box, I have a cylinder, I have a cube, and I want to place it somewhere here. And so how many lines of code do you think we need to make this? How many lines of code you have to write for this? Like I already showed you this is the hello world program. I mean, this is how you include everything. So how many of lines do you think we need to make this application, like to make this application in virtual world? Three lines?
100.
100. 100. Any numbers in the middle? 10. Yeah, it's near to 3. So it's 4. Yeah. Yes. So it's 4. So what you are actually doing is, what objects do you have? You have a sphere, okay. You have a box, okay. You have a cylinder, 3 objects. And you have a plane on the horizontal ground. Okay, 4 objects. So I probably need 4 lines of code. So okay, let's see how to code this. So I'll show you this example directly. Then we'll see how it works. Examples. Everything is on aframe.io, so you don't need to worry about way to find any resources. So yeah, so this is the virtual world. I'll go to full screen. Yeah. So this is virtual world. So if you want to place any objects on the backside, yeah, move it. You'll be able to place this. And yeah, again we got it. So like you can go around the place. You can place objects anywhere in this virtual world in this 360 degrees. And now let's see the coding part. So now we got the example and everything. Yeah. So yeah, this is all the code we need. You can see it, right? So the same hello world format, we wrote it HTML script, and then we opened the A scene, and then we wrote the box, cylinder, sphere, plane, and yeah, the sky is for adding the background. So here we added a gray background, right? So yeah. So yeah, there we added a gray background. Also, it's not only about color. So if you want to, if you captured a 360 degree image at London Eye or Marina Bay, you can add it to the background of this application. So in the sky, instead of color, give it as source, src equal to the length, and you will get the background of the image there itself on the screen. Yeah, that one also I'll try to show it. Yeah, there's a workshop, right? So I'll show you all the demos as well. So this is the image. Yes, so yeah, this is the captured 360 degrees image. Yeah, so all the virtual reality demos which I'm running right now, they're all completely running on browser. I didn't install any applications, any software, neither to build it or not to view the output. So everything is in running on browser. So I'm using a browser, and then I'm running all the examples on the browser. So now what I'll put instead of this one, I'll view the source also. Let's view the source, like how many lines of code it takes. Yeah, I got the source. So it uses only one line of code. That's it. So if you put a VR headset and then have a look at it, you will actually enjoy the virtual real space. So it uses only one line. That too, for setting the background of your virtual world with a 360 degrees image. That's it. It's very easy to code. It's very easy to share. So now someone made this, and someone hosted it on GitHub or any place, and they put the link here. So I'm able to view the content. So now I can combine both of things. So would you, do you want me to combine both the things? I don't think I have the image, but yeah. So if, I will show you. Yeah. You have this hello webVR, and we'll view the source as well. So now, okay, I'll zoom in. Yes. So here you have everything. You have box, cylinder, plane, etc. And in the sky, A sky color, so instead of this one, I'll put this one. Where is that? Yeah, A sky, this type. So instead of adding the color to the background, it adds the image. I didn't do any coding, like 5 lines of code, and I got my virtual reality application up and running. You can directly store it in an index.html and then view it. And I'll show you one powerful example. So these are the basic, simple examples, right? So I'll show you one powerful example, and I'll tell you how we can integrate the previous talk. Previous talk was about WebRTC, right? So we'll see how we can, I'll tell you how we can use that WebRTC platform to make your virtual reality application. Yeah, so this is it. So this, since I don't have the controller, so I bought this video to show it to you. So the person was at his office cubicle, and he's playing table tennis with some other person who is at his own cubicle. And they meet in a virtual world. So this is. So she's painting with a VR headset on her face and two controllers. So one left controller she is using as a color palette, and the right controller she is using it as a paintbrush to brush things on the virtual world. In reality, it will be like just this room. But in the virtual world, she's painting amazing things using this one. And he's playing a game. So he's using his left controller as a shield and right controller as a hammer. Yeah. Can you pass me the charger? Laptop charger, yeah. So this is basketball game. So they are playing just, they are having their controllers, and they are just playing basketball in whatever room they are in. Yeah. Thank you. So the applications are endless for this. So now you have already seen three applications. One is Painter, one is the one which we showed in the beginning, like the table tennis. And all these applications are made using simple HTML. If you know HTML, then you will be able to make the applications, virtual reality applications. I think it's starting.
Check your,
shut down already.
Yeah.
Oh.
It was charged, but yeah.
It's the power on?
Yeah.
Ah, you're using the wrong one.
Okay. Yeah, it's it's running.
This
Do you think we can just turn over on this?
Yeah, sure. We can pass them out. So
if anybody wants to try, we have these samples.
So, I was telling you about how we can combine the WebRTC which we are showing, right? So WebRTC was the previous talk. So we are two people, I mean, it's a peer-to-peer communication. So when it comes to the virtual world, so we have we saw the table tennis example, right? So two people are meeting in the virtual world, and they are playing table tennis. And one person is painting this. So if we combine the WebRTC technology in here, two people can meet in a virtual world and they can paint things. Like I'm here and my friend is in India. So, and we got a great idea, and in the next hour. So we meet in the virtual world and we paint those ideas in the virtual world. And the application is already up and running. So I told you about the website, right? aframe.io. So it's already up and running there. So you can go there, run your application. So basically, that runs on any hardware headset, but you need the controllers for painting and painting brush and the color palette.
Yeah.
So yeah. So she is trying to paint things in the virtual world with the controllers and VR headset on her eyes. So that's how she said. So this is another game. Yeah, we spoke about that. So the applications are endless. Like this is a fighting game. So you can have a controllers and you can play boxing with your friend as well. If you want to develop an application, yeah, you can develop it as well. And this is basketball game. And they are playing everything. They don't need any equipment or anything. They can just go into the virtual world and they can play things. The painter and most of these applications are already made and already hosted on aframe.io. You just need headsets to play them. And yeah, so these are other applications. So they're playing another game. Shooting game. So the it's like the applications are still endless. So like if you have an idea, you can start working on it. Like I was showing you how many lines of code it actually takes to build your virtual world. So this is how easy it is. Yeah. Now we got your virtual world and how it actually works. So the webVR actually works on entity component relationships. So for example, if you have heard about class and object and inheritance, like for example, so this is what I have, the entity. For sphere, I was writing in the Hello World program, I was writing a sphere and then gave the coordinates, then I gave the color, right? So that is actually a wrapper around this one. So I declared an entity and then gave the geometry, like it should be a sphere. And then I give what kind of material it should be, what kind of position it should be, and where, how much should I rotate the entity. And instead of all this, I was just using that A sphere and then giving the these objects. So it's like this is an entity and that's the main component. So you can, based on this entity, you can create your own component. For example, if I want to create a box, I was using A box tag. So instead of that, so I declare an entity, then give the primitive as box. So it's like in A-frame, we are making it simpler. We are making the things simpler to use, to code, and to develop application to share it with people. So yeah, so these are a few components which we have included in A-frame, like we have position, we have rotation. So these are basic primitives or components which we have. But web is open, and anyone interested in working on web, anyone interested in web can start contributing to it. And that's how we got all these components. Like, we integrated only few components, but people are so excited, and people want to develop web applications, the web virtual reality applications. And yeah, they made it happen with the help of this web VR. So now we have a lot of components, and we'll have like at least a component added to the marketplace every month. So that's like, it's always a continuous innovation process going on in WebRTC. So if you want to develop WebVR applications, you are welcome. If you want to contribute to the projects also, you can make your own component and share it with the people. And yeah, so let's get to our work. So this was our main agenda, right? So let's build our own Pokemon world. So what would be your first step? So think of a Pokemon world, and what do you think you need?
Scene,
yes. Background image, yeah. And what else do we need?
So you need the Pokemon.
Yeah, Pokemons. Yeah, we are building the Pokemon world, and so we need Pokemons, and
then you need the controller.
Yeah, controller. If you want to interact with the Pokemons, you need the controllers. So yeah. Huh?
And then sound.
Sound, yes. So regarding that sound, it's simple. Like how you integrate the sound in your website. So it's same thing. So you don't need to learn any extra things. So okay. So if you like, I think audio tag you use in HTML to include a audio file into your website. So use the same thing for this. So it's simple. You don't need to learn anything. So one component we are done. We already coded it. So if you search for HTML audio tag, so you will get the code. So one component, we have already coded it. Now we have left with the scene, we have Pokemons, we have controllers. Okay, now we don't have controllers, but we'll code the first two parts. So the controllers also, we have good resources to to start developing. And now we have the scene, and we have the Pokemons. So to make it interesting, we'll do one thing. Instead of Pokemon images, Pokemon images are stationary, right? So we'll do one thing. We'll use the GIF images, .gif images. So they'll be a transition. They just move. So it looks beautiful, right? So instead of stationary images, it looks beautiful. So yeah, now, so this is what we need. So we need a background image, we need Pokemons, images or GIFs, and then we need few A tags. So what A tags we should use? What code we should use? What A tags?
A-tag.
So the code for box, we are using A box. So what tags do we need for inserting a background image?
A sky,
yes. A sky, we can give it the color or else a box. So we already got one. So now the first thing is done. We inserted a background image. And next, Pokemon images. How do we insert them in the virtual space?
HRC.
Yeah, SRC, we'll use the SRC tag and then insert it. And yeah, so that will be a plane, right? So we'll include the plane. Like, so we can actually include the Pokemons around a cube, like on all sides of a cube or all sides of a cylinder. But to make it like really real, so we use a plane, and on top of that, we'll have this GIF images. So yeah, we'll have that A sky to include the background, and A plane with SRC to include the GIF images, and what else do we need? That's it. Yeah, let's build it. So GIF images, so like I was telling you, like few components are already included, but yeah, many components are developed by volunteers. So when I got this idea, so I thought, okay, let's search if there is an component where you could play the GIF images on the browser, like on the browser in virtual world. So I found this. So there is a guy called as Mayo Tobita. He's interested in virtual reality. So he spent a weekend and developed a component for that. So this A-frame, the first line, aframe.min.js, we are already including in all our A-frame enabled applications, right? So now we include another two, A-frame GIF shader and A-frame GIF component. So I'll share the presentation with you after the talk. Yeah. So now we got these two min.js, so we include it in our HTML file. And yeah, now we have the libraries, we have the sky, we have the background, and now we need to use a plane and to just put the Pokemons around in our virtual world. Yeah. So now what would be the next step? Embedding a Pokemon GIF. So I was using the entity, the normal thing, entity geometry primitive plane. So instead of this, you can actually write a plane. I'm writing it as a like an entity, but you can write a plane, a sphere, or anything. So and in that a plane, I'm giving a position, like it should be -2, 0.5, -5. So what does it mean? Okay, I'm here. So -2. This is positive x axis, positive y axis, and positive z axis. So -2 in the sense, this one will be -2, and I mean I'm telling from my direction. That will be opposite for you. Okay, yeah. And then 0.5 in y-axis. So this is -2 and this is 0.5. So they meet at this point, okay. And then -5. So -5 is away from the ground. So it will move and the object will be at some point over there. And so yeah, we got the position and we are rotating it with 90 degrees on y-axis. So let's see how it rotates. Like we are rotating the plane with 90 degrees. So let's see how we'll get the Pokemon embedded into our view. And then we have a scale 2:2:2. Scale 2:2:2 is like, so actually when I search for GIF images, I got only very small GIF images. So I'm scaling it to become large. So 2:2:2 in the sense like the size will be doubled. And yeah, what else do I need? I need material, shader GIF. So that's in the component, like if you are inserting a GIF component, you should write shader colon GIF, or else it will take it as an image and it won't create the GIF transition. So we'll write the shader GIF, and then so source URL, I'm using the media.tenor.co, that's where I found the GIF images. So I embedded my Pokemon into the virtual world. So now I have that sky and I have this. So my Pokemon world should be ready. Okay, so let me see. And what is the next step? Oh, we don't have any next step. So we are done with our Pokemon world. So I just spent an hour yesterday to make my own Pokemon world. So I'll share it with you like how it looks. I hosted it on my GitHub so that anyone can view it. A frame boilerplate, yes. Okay. Yeah, I got my Psyduck here, it got stuck. So basically, yeah, we have a Charmeleon running on its tail, and we have Pokemon, we have a Pikachu, who is a cheerleader in my virtual world. We will go near to the Pikachu. Hey, what is it doing? Okay, it's playing with its own. Yeah, we have a Snorlax. So like, So this was a world, and I placed the Snorlax on the back for reasons, like it's saying hi to you. Like in the virtual world, like you are this, and you suddenly move around, and you will find the Snorlax staring at you, waving his hand. So yeah, and one thing you can see this, like I have a sky here, like I gave an image, but I used a plane, like this white color plane. Also, this is just to hide, one irregularity, like I can see it. So, the GIF images which you generally find on internet, so they have either a background or a white background, right? So, when you insert it into the virtual world, so this is how it looks, the Snorlax, you can see it, right? So, it will have a white background and your GIF will be moving. So, to hide that problem, so I just use this... this plane, white plane, so that even these Pokemon and this Charmeleon got a white background. But yeah, you can't see it because I'm hiding it with the plane. I'm intelligent, yeah. So now, yeah, we have Psyduck, which is swimming in its own. Yeah, we have Eve, who is jumping. So I just grab few things, and yeah, Wigglepuff looks angry with this. Yeah, what is it doing? No. Oh, she doesn't want to show herself to the demo, has in the demo, yeah. So, this is like just a simpler virtual world which I created, yeah. And it's not stable, the GIF component, it's not stable for now because the frame rate of GIF is very high and the component, it's like he made it as a hobby. So, it's not stable, but yeah. So, but still you can use it, like if you want to create your own virtual world, so this is how simple it is. And yeah, we'll think about, that was not included, so I think we have enough time, right? Yeah, we have still, how much time do we have?
We have another 30.
Yeah, we have another 30 minutes. So we will also see, I have not made it yet, but I'm getting this idea. So let's build this Pokemon world in augmented reality. Like Pokemons will be sitting among you, yourselves. So if there are empty chairs, we'll put Pokemons into there. So we might not be able to make it by the end of this demo, but yeah, I'll show you how we can make it. So yeah, so this is how you build the Pokemon world in virtual reality. And I'll show you the code, okay? I lost the internet. Do we have internet here?
Yeah.
I'm not getting it.
Is this FOSSASIA Wi-Fi?
Yeah.
Yes, we are
stable. Yeah, too many devices. Let me see if I already opened it. Yes, I think I already opened it. Yeah, so this is what I did. I put this, this one. A sky equal to BG image. So I'm inserting the background image. So I'm using, instead of giving the URL, I'm using this hash BG image, and this BG image I'll write an ID. So that one I wrote it at the top. So BG image, and it should be panorama background.jpg. And I'm using this ID name and write it as slash ID in the source. And now we got this background image. So this is the whole of the code which I needed. Now I got it. Now I got the background image. So basically why I did is like I can use the source and insert the URL onto the page. But if I want to change image, then again I have to search for the A-Sky tag or anything. But now it's simple for me. Like I'll find all the images which I used in my demo here. And if I want to change anything, it's easy for me to edit. So it's just a good practice, that's it. But it's not necessary. You can directly write the source and inside this A-Sky itself. And now let's see the Pokemon. So I commented, I write good code. So I commented, like, so this is the Wigglepuff plane. This is the position of that Wigglepuff. And yeah, this is everything. This is for Charmander. This is for Eve. This is for Snorlax. This is for Psyduck. This is for Pikachu. So we were talking about this -1, -2, 0.5, and -5, right? So that should be somewhere there. And Wigglepuff was there, right? So when we open the, I'll get the Wi-Fi, I'll demo it again, yeah. It's connecting. Connected, open, yeah, where is it? Yes. So this is all the code I wrote, that's it. I didn't wrote anything much. See, it got 69 lines of code, and in that half of the code is already commented. So with this 30 lines of code, I created my, yeah. So see, now this is my camera. You can see this dot, right? This dot, black color dot, can you see it? So that is my camera. So this is my camera, and my wiggle puff is located somewhere on the left side of the camera. And side is on the right side. So that means it should have a positive x-axis and negative z-axis and some y-axis. So let's see our code. Where is it? Yeah. So, and that was side arc, we have like a positive x-axis, yes, and positive y-axis 0.3 and negative z-axis. So this is how you position it, and the rotations is also like, for example, in a demo, we have like Eve on the left side. So let's see to what angle it is rotated. Yeah, we have Eve here, and we have rotated the y-axis by 90. So this is y-axis, and we rotated it by 90 degrees. So like when you look towards the left side, you will see Eve on there. And the same thing, like this is located, the snow lax is located 180 degrees. So this is our main plane, and we rotated it 180 degrees. So the snow lax will be here. So in this way, you will give the position, you will give the rotation, you will give the length to the images. And yeah, now you have your own Pokemon world playing around, in your virtual reality. And also, one more thing to add, we got this idea when we were demoing it our booth yesterday, like, now instead of adding this plane, so we'll have few white clouds, and inside that clouds we'll put this Pokemon to hide that white background. It looks natural, right? So more than having this plane and over this, having this Pokemon, it looks more natural. So that was the idea we got at our booth itself. And now let's, this is how you make it. Any doubts? Yeah, if you have any questions other than this thing, yeah, we'll discuss it in the end. Like, so now we have our Pokemon world in virtual reality. So let's see how we can make the same thing in augmented reality. We have, even that one I was searching if I can make it in augmented reality, and there is already component someone created. So this all things are running on the browser. If you observe one thing, these all things are running on your browser. It doesn't need any software. So on browser, if for example, if you are using, if you are capturing a camera, I mean, if you are capturing a photo or video from the Facebook on the browser itself, so it opens your camera, right? So because it gets the user media, like the camera access or the photo access or every way to the web page using basic JavaScript. So we will use the same user media API, get user media API, and we'll get the access to camera. So whatever the camera sees, we should get the same thing on the virtual world. And then we'll put the Pokemons around the world, around in the augmented reality. Yeah, so we already have this is A-frame, right? So we have A-frame AR, that's augmented reality. Using your real world, using your real world and getting some virtual objects into your real world. Okay, I found one augmented reality, this one. Yeah, so now I think I already cloned this one. So let me open the code directly on my local. Where is it? Development. Yeah, A-frame AR, I already have it. And yeah, index.html, I'm just, this is a basic HTML code. And I open with Firefox, yes. Yes. Okay, and it's asking me for permissions to use my webcam. Okay, and yeah, I'll allow for this time. Okay, now we got it. This one is a Bulbasaur, but yeah, I'll change it to a good image, good nice image. We have a duck also. So yeah, I put an image here. This is Bulbasaur. But since it has only unique color, so I have it. So if you have the virtual headset, then you can move around and see. So, but yeah, since it's on the desktop, you are not able to see it. So yeah, so now I got some object into the real world. That's how augmented reality works. Let's see. If the duck example was really good, but yeah, let me see autonome.github.io. So let's see if we hosted it, so that, I mean, it will be easy for us to check it. Yeah. Okay. I'm closing it. And yeah, even that example is asking us for camera access. Yeah. Okay, now we have this duck. Now you can see this duck, right? So it, we brought it into the real world. So we are using the camera, and which shows us, I mean, since this is a desktop, you can't see it in a very, very really good way. But if it's in a mobile, so if the duck is there, so you will see the duck sitting on the floor along with your people. So and, let's see how much code it actually got in this autonome. So this aframe.js, which we already included in our framework, this is camera.js, which he created for his own. So we can just clone it, and like I did the same thing. I just copied this code, and then instead of this duck.obj, I included a bulbasaur.obj. Where is it? Yeah, I included a bulbasaur.obj. That's it. I didn't made any changes. I just made it, and yeah. I'll show you the demo on the mobile phone in the end, so that you will know. And let's see what code it actually got on the index.html. So yeah, so this is a simple styling code. And we have assets. So we included a duck.obj with source ducky.obj. And then we included, where is that? This one, yeah, okay. So yeah, so we included this ducky obj. This is a 3D file, 3D image file. So, and then we colored, we added it to the, using this AA object model. And then we gave the position, we gave the rotation, we gave the scales, like it was small in the beginning, but we enlarged it to 8x. Then we colored it with orange. And that's how we got this one, the augmented, the duck in the augmented reality. So if you have your own mobile device, so you can go to that website, enable VR mode, and then have a look at duck. So you can try it right now itself. It's hosted already. The URL is, if you want to try have the duck in your mobile phones, it's easy. Go to autonome, yeah, github.io. Yeah, this is the thing. Notepad. autonome.github.io/aframe-am. Open on your browser. You don't need to install any application. Just open on your browser, go to that URL, and you will see, and just you will see the duck on your virtual space, on the augmented space around you. Yes.
You take the OBJ file, right?
Yes. Yeah, even yeah, that's a good question. Like, way to find OBJ file. Even I don't know how to build that in 3D space. So what I did was,
I can do OBJ. I'm saying, can you do some topology on the OBJ? You join, you know, you join two different, because they are all polygons.
Yes, yes, so yes.
You join various OBJ and do collision. That's my thing.
I didn't actually get your question.
It's like you can build a lot of characters. And
yes.
It's like a game, you know?
Yes, yes,
and
yes.
They can move.
Yes, yes.
So it's quite easily achieved, right? Is it correct to say that? Like objects 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yes.
They're doing a dance.
Okay. Yeah. Yes, so the animation in OBJ.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, okay. So the animation in OBJ also, we can have it. So if you look at the A-frame tags, you will have like A animation. So, and it works with almost everything. Like if you want a box to animate, you can do that. If you want a sphere to animate, you can do that. So basically, the animate works like this. So for example, your object is at one point, and you want to enlarge it to 2, 2, 2. So you will write like A animation from scale 0, 0, 0 2 scale 333. So, and you will give the time like 1 second or 10 milliseconds or anything, and it enlarges. So we have that code as well. Yeah, just a minute. Aframe.io. And okay, I don't have internet, but yeah. So go to aframe.io. There you will have a search for a animation tag. So you can animate any object using that. So how many of you found the duck on the website? You found the duck, yeah? Yes, you got the duck. So you can move around the space. So instead of that full screen, you can actually enable that VR mode and use the cardboard box which I provided. You can put in that and then view the duck in the virtual space, in the augmented space, sorry. Yeah, so where are the VR boxes? VR box? Do you have it?
It's around there somewhere.
Yeah, so if you want to try it, you can use those VR boxes and you can. It works with any phone. So you can put your phone in the inside that box and then look at the space around you in virtual world.
Like 5 minutes.
Yeah, thank you. I think, yeah, I'm almost done. Yes. So now we embedded the Pokemon and we thought about, like, discussed about how to build the Pokemon world in augmented reality. And yeah, so I told you, right, Aframe is an open source project built by Mozilla. It's open. You don't need to, Mozilla doesn't charge you anything. So we have, like, contributors, we have, like, 130 contributors and 49,000 stargazers on GitHub. Like, 130 people are actually contributing to the Aframe project. Like, they are not building examples, they are actually contributing to the Aframe project. And we have like 1750 members on Slack. So it's like a group messaging client and hundreds of future projects. So for example, if you have made anything after going home using this WebVR, and if you share it with your with the Aframe team, and they will publish it on their own website. So for every week, they will release, like, this is a week of AR. So now I think it's 55th week of Aframe. So in that week, whatever good things that are made using Aframe, so they will feature it on the website. And yeah, so thank you. That's it from me.
You guys got questions?
Yeah.
Maybe let me start. One big question I think in VR is, how's it about hardware requirements?
It's not hardware dependent, so like I was telling you, right, this costs like $40, that costs like $4.
What about the phone? I mean, what about the graphics hardware?
No, it actually, the frame rate depends on your mobile device, right, and the browser.
What what kind of mobile device would I need to have a fluent, decent frame rate? Like, which generation would it work on?
So for this basic example, it runs on almost like all mobile devices. You are just including few HTML tags, right? But if you're making anything like a game, then it might require about like 1 or 2 GB of RAM. So pretty good RAM so that it has enough space for the browser to run. So it's similar to like if you open 100 websites on the browser. So it's like similar to that. So if you open a WebVR project, so it takes the same consumption like a website. So it doesn't take any other extra memory space.
Does it use WebGL?
Yes, absolutely. So it uses those augmented, the accelerometers in your mobile device. And when you move, so it detects that and generates the WebGL content on the browser using WebGL API, right. Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else with questions? Can we buy it?
Yes, I bought it on Amazon. Yeah, these are called as VR boxes. This is, the device name is Procus Pro. So if you search for VR boxes, you will have many options. So I learned these things with that basic box. That cost like only $4 for me on Amazon. That's called as VR box. And I learned with that. And then when I got confidence that, okay, I can work on a VR project, so then I bought this one. So I got like headphones. You can view some beautiful VR videos. So if you want to know more about, if you want to have a real experience of virtual reality, go to YouTube and search for VR videos. So that gives you, even if you're a beginner, you will know like what things you can do with virtual reality. Yeah. Yes, any other questions? as a user, as a developer, you can ask me any questions.
Alright, maybe you can catch him after the talk. So thanks, Santosh,
yeah,
for this awesome talk. We really very informative.
Thanks. Yeah, thank you. And yeah, you can comment, visit us at Mozilla.